Are Lapis and Peridot ever gonna like meet, like talk, or is that like spoilers?
Hi. Whenever anyone asks questions like this, it just pains because I want to tell people like exactly what, like everything I know, but unfortunately I can't. But I will say that one thing that's pretty cool about what Rebecca Sugar does to me specifically on the show, because she knows I watch the show, she will like only let me in on like pivotal plot points if they directly involve me, and then everything else is just a surprise most of the time. Okay. So sometimes I'm in the as in the dark as you guys are.
Okay, thank you.
So you had, do you have another question? I felt like you were gonna ask something else. Go for it.
What's it like to work with Rebecca and the other people?
Rebecca is a sweetheart, and everyone who works on Steven Universe, I love dearly. Every person on the cast and crew is phenomenal. It's honestly such an exciting experience, and it's honestly so mind-blowing that I'm a part of it.
Thank you.
No, and you've been a part of it since you were 15 years old.
Yeah, I auditioned for the role of Connie. I'm in my freshman year of college right now, but I auditioned for the role of Connie on one of my last days of my sophomore year of high school. And it's been a part of my life ever since, and it has definitely changed my life for the better.
Yeah, I was going to say, did you have any idea on the impact that Steven Universe would have?
I mean, all I knew was that I booked a role on a new Cartoon Network show, and I was a really big fan of Adventure Time at the time. So I was really, really excited, but I had no idea that it would grow to the magnitude that it did in the span of time that it did. And I remember when one of the first episodes came out, I would just like Google what people were saying about the show, and I would like look up on like Reddit or Tumblr what people were saying, and it was amazing seeing how from like the very first episodes, like maybe like 60 comments on something, and then all of a sudden it would become like 6,000 and like 12,000. I was like, this is really growing into something that, not to say that I didn't expect, but like I don't know what I expected. It just grew in front of my eyes.
And clearly we have a lot of Steven Universe fans here, right? Yeah. And I know you guys have questions, so come on. Come on, guys, step up to the microphone. She doesn't bite, from what I'm aware. We don't know each other that long, but... Anybody? Bueller? Okay, here we go.
Hello.
Yes. Yeah, best fusion. Next to go.
Oh my god, yes. Oh my god.
So my question is actually, what's your favorite song from the series so far?
Okay, so far.
If you want to go ahead and, you know.
Yeah, let me give you a sneak preview. No.
You do have an amazing voice. I got to see you do karaoke last night, and that was pretty amazing. Yeah, this girl's good.
It was kind of funny. Last weekend, I was sick, and I lost my voice. And I was like, oh, no, I just need to, like, really rest my voice. So that way, this upcoming weekend for Animate Miami, I have my voice back. And it came back, and everything was good. And then I started singing karaoke last night, and like the first song I did, I was just like, I'm pretty sure I like blew out my voice, and I was like, cool, this is great. But anyway, getting to your question, not to get too distracted. Hopefully this isn't cliche at all, but no. I love Stronger Than You.
Oh my god! Yes.
I love that song. It's amazing. Estelle, I haven't actually met Estelle yet, but she's phenomenal.
No regrets. I have no regrets.
Yes.
Back together. And I'm never going down.
Bring it to the microphone.
Because I'm so much
better. Well, I was going to see if you wanted to play it into the microphone. So we can all hear it. No? Why not? It's that kind of party.
Can I have a brief dance intermission?
This is Garnet. Back together.
Everyone sing along.
And I'm never going down at the hands of the likes of you, because I'm so much better. And every part of me is saying go get her.
The two of us ain't gonna follow your rules. Come at me without any of your fancy tools. Let's go, just me and you. Let's go, just one on two. Go ahead and try to hit me if you're able. Can't you see that my relationship is stable? I can see you hate the way we intermingle, but I think you're just mad cause you're single. And you're gonna do the style what we made together. We are gonna stay like this forever. If you break us apart, we'll just come back you up. And we'll always be twice the gem that you are. I am a
I have a fun story about that song. I actually got to hear an early version of it with like some of the storyboarding, and it was probably the only time that Rebecca Sugar actually like told me something really big in the show that didn't directly involve Connie. Ahead of time, we finished recording an episode shortly after Full Disclosure, and I asked her a question because there was something in the script that didn't really make much sense, given the fact that I had no idea that Garnet was a fusion at the time, and I was like, wait, what? And she was like, oh, Grace, come up to my office and I'm going to show you something that we're working on right now. And she showed me some like light storyboarding of the Stronger Than You sequence. And I was like, oh my God, this is so cool.
Well, to go along with the favorite song that you asked, do you have a favorite episode?
One of my favorites. Okay. I'll separate this into two categories, an episode that I'm in and an episode I'm not in. One of my favorite episodes that I'm not in is Keep Beach City Weird, because I absolutely love Ronaldo. I think he is one of the funniest characters, and, being an, avid user of the internet, there's a lot of like subtle references that are like snuck into everything that Ronaldo says, and I think it's the funniest thing ever. And as far as one of my favorite episodes that I was in, I think Open Book was one of the most fun to record and one of the most fun episodes to watch back afterwards. it was really fun getting to play both Rose's Room version Connie and real Connie, and it was really funny in the recording booth, because we didn't really separate it when I was recording it. It kind of just jumped back and forth from me being like Steven, I know what you really want. And then like be like, no, Steven. And just like jumping back and forth. That was really fun just to watch back. And also, I loved recording all of Connie's really nerdy theories about unfamiliar and the story of Arkham Icarus. I was like, the whole anti-authoritarian themes, all of those lines where she talks about watering down the true meaning of the book for a wider audience appeal, that just... Honestly, I will get the scripts for the show and just laugh in my room reading them, because they're so well written, and I think everyone on the show behind the scenes are just so talented.
So you're friends with a lot of people outside of the show?
Oh,
or the cast that you work with?
Yeah. Do you mean like the people who work behind the scenes, or just...
Well, sure. Or the other voice actors?
Oh yeah. I talk to them occasionally. It's been really cool hanging out with Zach this weekend so far, getting to spend his 18th birthday with him. But yeah, no, it's been fun. It's been cool getting to watch how being a part of Steven Universe has impacted Zach and I, as we both started working. Well, I started working on it when I was 15, and I think probably around the same. I'm like 2 weeks older than Zach, so we're about the same age.
And you've been at this for a really long time.
Yeah, like, I started acting when I was 4 years old. I got in the industry really early. I remember my dad was like, or just my sometime. In my early childhood, I was offered the opportunity to get into all of this, and I didn't really know what I was getting myself into at the time, but I was like, yeah, I want to be on TV. That sounds awesome. Like, four-year-old me is like, cool, I could be on, like, Disney Channel or something. But, yeah, it's been a part of my life for as long as I can remember, really. But I try to balance... this side of my life and the, not like the real side of my life, but the more normal side. I went to a public high school, and I'm a college student at a actual university, so it's cool. I get to have the best of both worlds, and I don't mean that in like the Hannah Montana way, but
that is a good way though.
You know, going out, take it slow, then you rock out the show.
So what do you like to do, like, in your spare time when you're not recording for Steven Universe? Like, what are your hobbies?
I love music. I love playing guitar. I also play the bass. I love hanging out with my friends, just listening to music. I read in my spare time. Right now, I'm reading On the Road by Jack Kerouac. I don't know. School's keeping me pretty busy right now, but I'm an advertising major right now.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
All right. Any other questions? Come on, guys. Yeah. Come on down. There's a microphone right here.
Two questions, actually. One, who would you like to record a song with from Steven Universe?
Ooh. See, who have... Okay. Well, let's see here. I'm trying to think. I mean, it would be so awesome to record a song with Estelle, just for obvious reasons. Yeah. I feel like that's the most, like, clear, like, answer that I can easily say. Honestly, I would love to record a song with any character in that show, though. So, like, hey, if any of the writers end up watching this, Grace is down to sing more songs for Steven Universe. Just putting that out there.
And the second question, I know you can't tell us anything, but in your opinion, who do you want to meet next in the show? Like, which gem?
Oh, sorry. Who do I want to work with, or like who Connie?
Like the character.
Okay, yeah, Connie. Without giving too much away, I would say that Connie is a very brave character, and I hope that she helps Steven with a lot of what is coming up in the Crystal Gems future. No, that's not a spoiler. That's not a spoiler. I'm just saying that Connie, in some way or another, is a very supportive person to Steven, and in some way, whether emotional or physical, she's going to be helping Steven somehow.
Thank you.
Come on down. Question, you guys can just line up or, you know.
Okay, so I have two questions. One, what was it like doing Stevani with Zach? Because it's like a combination of both of your voices.
Yeah, actually, the voice of Stevani is actually AJ Mishaka. I don't know if you know Ali and AJ from back in the day, but yeah, Stevani is played by AJ Mishaka. And when I got to work with her, I actually freaked out because Ali and AJ was my first concert that I ever went to. But it was actually really cool because one of the funny stories that from that day of recording was AJ took great care to really incorporate both Steven's signature laugh and Connie's signature laugh and like combine it into one. So we went into the studio, Zach and I, and he did his laugh and I did my laugh, and it was amazing how AJ just kind of like mixed them together. I don't know. It was really cool.
Cool. One more. When you watch your own episodes, if you do, what do you think would be probably the weirdest, most confusing episode? I'm not saying that I don't like it. I love it, but
no, I do watch my own episodes, and as you guys can tell, Connie's voice isn't exactly the same as my speaking voice.
Can we hear Connie's voice?
Yes, I'm able to distance myself at least a little bit from it when I'm watching the show, and I can like kind of take a step back and be like, okay, that's not Grace, that's Connie. So it's not like overly self-indulgent and like can see I'm watching myself talk. My show is my favorite show. No, but yeah, as far as weirdest things to watch back, Open Book was strange. Open Book was strange to watch back, just because like it was two me's, one good and one arguably evil.
Talking to yourself?
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you.
No problem.
Have you ever like accidentally slipped into your Connie voice and then people was like, "Oh my God, you're Connie"?
No, but. Something really funny happened during my orientation week at my college. There was a girl I was sitting next to one day, I was talking to her. We struck up a conversation, and she was just like, "Wow, you speak really well. Like you're so articulate. You should like be paid to talk." I would listen to that. I was like, weird.
Okay, so I have two questions. One's a little controversial. I will say I am a Steven Universe fan, absolutely love it, but I am also a Brony. And my first question is, for Cartoon Network, have you met some of the people that run like Cartoon Network, the network itself?
I mostly know most of the creatives in the department. I know a few people part of the more business and network aspect, but not too many people know.
So, like, what's your overall impression of them? Are they?
I honestly love the people at Cartoon Network overall. Overall, yeah.
And my second question is, you said you go spend a bit amount of time online. Do you know about the drama that's been going on between the Steven Universe fandom and the Bronies? And what's your opinion on it? Yes, I went there.
I'm actually not aware of that specific. Feud, but So I can't really give an informed opinion, but I will say that I do sometimes, not all of the time, but I do sometimes peruse the Steven Universe subreddit and the Steven Universe tag on Tumblr. I don't post anything, but I just kind of like look around.
Have you been to the Steven Universe fan site, Beach City Bulge?
I haven't actually. I didn't know that existed.
Oh yeah, it's big.
Well,
thank you.
Now I know.
Hey.
Hello again.
All right. I think, does anyone who voices Connie's parents, their voice actors?
Crispin Freeman.
And Mary Elizabeth Winstead.
Yes, yeah.
How would you feel if they recorded a song with you? And how is it like working with them?
That's actually a really cute idea. I wonder, that is a cute idea.
Mary Elizabeth is a great singer.
I haven't heard her sing, but I have heard that she is a good singer.
Waiting For You from Silent Hill 4. It's a good one. She sings it.
No, yeah. Crispin Freeman is really fun to work with. And also, so is Mary Elizabeth. But yeah, that would be really fun. I would not be opposed to that at all.
Also, I want you to say, allow me to cut through those words in your Connie voice. I'll say it with you.
allow me to cut through those words.
Hello.
Hey. Love the outfit, by the way.
Thank you. So I have two questions for you. What is probably the weirdest thing you've been asked to do for your role? Because I know voice actors have to do like all sorts of crazy things.
Oh, for my role. I remember one time. Oh, I mean, this isn't a spoiler. This episode hasn't aired yet, so I don't know if they use this take or not. But there was one line where they're like, "Can you just say this one line in like a southern accent? Just try it." I was like. Okay, so I don't know if they ended up using it, so we'll find out eventually. But that was pretty funny and out of nowhere. I mean, it wasn't out of nowhere, but that was pretty funny. Also, there was one time where Zach and I had to talk with actual marshmallows in our mouths for winter forecast.
Aww.
That's probably one of my fondest memories.
And then the other question, like before you were cast, is there any other characters be like, oh, it'd be kind of cool to see like what they do, or like you watch like the other episodes and be like, imagine if I had to do that.
Oh, well, I mean, I booked the role of Connie before Steven Universe aired, so I've been a part of it since close to the beginning. But I was huge. I mentioned I was a huge Adventure Time fan before the start of Steven Universe, and I always was like, before the audition even came up, I was like, it would be so cool to work on a cartoon for Cartoon Network, so this is really a dream come true.
Well, thank you.
No problem.
I have two questions. The first one is, I don't want to be that person, but do you ship anything on the show?
Yeah. Well,
Steve Audi FTW.
Yeah. See, well, I love Ruby Sapphire, obviously. Obviously. Yeah, most of my ships are all canon. I think all the writers know what they're doing.
Okay. And wait, I'm taking like two videos, so I have to. I forgot what I was gonna ask. If I were to ask you to like say something in Connie's voice, would you say it?
Depends.
Can you scream John Cena in Connie's voice?
Oh my god! Okay. Thank you for this question. do I have an inch? Can you pull up the track where it goes da 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 da?
Okay.
Because that needs to be at the ready if this is actually going to happen.
You get it? No, yeah, play the song.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm sure, but most of you guys have heard like the legendary John Cena prank call, right?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Okay, yes. Cool. Yeah. This might be the no I Is this the song or is it? Okay, yeah. I wasn't sure if it was the start of the prank call video. John Cena!
Oh my god. Thank you. My life is complete now.
Thank you.
Hi. I would like to ask you, which is your favorite episode from Steven Universe and why?
Okay. Well, okay. I mentioned Keep Beach City Weird earlier just because it has a lot of like funny I think that episode is particularly funny. Open Book was particularly fun and a challenge to work on. I think another one of my favorite episodes to work on and then watch the product of was Sworn to the Sword. One of the things when I first got the role of Connie, I was super excited, but I was a little worried that she would just be the lame human friend who was just like always hidden in Steven's shadow. Not in the sense where it's like, oh, I wish I had like a more pivotal role. It wasn't like that, but I just didn't want her to be Yes, exactly. I didn't want her to be the cliche person who was just there to like make Steven feel special. But as time has gone on, it's been so fun to watch Connie grow into this really strong and passionate character. And I love playing Connie, and I think Sworn to the Sword is when you can really see that Connie really, even though I know I am just a human, she's really strong in her own way.
Thank you.
Hey, Fidel, Dragon Ball Z. Okay, so my question for you is, which has got to be your least favorite episode?
Least favorite episode? Ooh. Least favorite episode. Don't get me wrong, Cat Fingers is an amazing episode. But the first time I saw that, I was like, oh my god, I am so freaked out right now. every time I see the scene where Steven is crawling through the car wash, I am just like, this is hard to watch. But it's a great episode, but that definitely gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Okay, thank you.
No problem.
Oh, hi. There we go. I have two questions. Do you know if Steven is going to fuse with any other gems or humans?
Well, it's already been confirmed that Steven can fuse with me. But I'm not at liberty to give away anything. And if it doesn't directly involve me, odds are I don't know anyway.
And my second question is, if Steven could fuse with anybody, like a gem or a human, who would you want him to fuse with?
What would be interesting? That would be funny. That would be real. That would be a very chaotic personality. I could see that fusion being pretty unstable. I wonder what a Steven Peridot fusion would be like. What? I wonder. Interesting. Anyway, yeah. Me? Oh, yeah.
Hi.
Hey.
I wasn't here throughout the entire thing. I just got here now, and I heard you guys sing Stronger Than Me or Stronger Than You, so I was just like, okay. My question, I don't know if anyone already asked this, is what is your favorite thing being Connie?
Definitely one of my favorite things is getting to watch the character of Connie grow in a because I love that all of the characters on Steven Universe, there are really no static characters. All of the characters on the show really grow a lot over the course of the seasons and even in the course of a single episode. So I think that's one of my favorite parts of playing Connie, just getting to bring her evolution to life. But also, I just think Connie is such a good character, and I just feel so honored that I get to play her.
Okay. Second question. Don't know if anyone already asked this, but what's your favorite fusion?
I love Stevani for very personal and conceited reasons. let's see. Sardonyx is awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Hey.
What was your reaction when you found out Peridot was going to be captured by the crystal gems?
Well, I remember watching the most recent Steven Universe episodes, and I was just like on the edge of my seat. Like, I was super into it because it's so weird. It's weird talking about how into Steven Universe I am because it feels strange knowing that I'm a part of it, because I kind of have to separate it for when I'm like appreciating it, and then when I realize that I am a part of it, I'm like, oh my god, wow. But yeah, no, I was watching it on the couch, watching Steven Universe on the couch with my parents, and I was like, probably like along with everyone else.
Thank you.
Can I give you something?
Sure. Oh, fortune cookie. Shit. Wait.
Open it.
Yeah, let me open it up and read what I get.
Brief moment.
Drum roll.
Imagine if it's a really bad fortune.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
There you go, and you have a good fellow cast,
yeah,
for Steven Universe, so it's
Steven
kind of
Universe
fitting.
Steven Universe has a great team, so I kind of am living the dream with my team. It's working out pretty well. Hello again.
Sorry, it's me again. You said how like you're always like on the tag on Tumblr and stuff. Do you have a Tumblr?
I don't. I mean, I have used Tumblr in the past, but I don't have one. But if I ever do make a Tumblr that any of you guys can follow, I will definitely let all the fans know somehow.
And also, like you said, how you look through the tags. Are there any like blogs that you like favorite blogs?
I couldn't name any off the top of my head, but. I love getting to see what the fans think of the show, and it's certainly really exciting for me to see how in depth some of the fans really look at things. And I know it is a cartoon and like a kid's show, no less, but there's so much thought and effort that goes into the writing of the episodes, and it's nice to see how much the fans really appreciate that and see that.
Thank you.
Hello again.
Hey.
So I was thinking about a project that I did with some of my friends in school, and we were to make a city, and we made Beach City because we all like Steven Universe. So I was thinking about if Beach City was real, you were actually in Beach City, and hold on, you were a gem, what gem would you be, and what would you do?
Oh wait, are we talking about like which crystal gem would I be, or like or
whatever whatever you
okay
want.
This is not Connie, this is Grace. I think if I were a gem, I would probably be amethyst if I were one of the crystal gems. most likely. I mean, I relate to a little bit of all three, but I definitely would have the most fun being amethyst. Opal's a fusion, though. I feel like I would love to say that my gemstone would be Opal, but that's already a character.
Pearl is a perfectionist. Amethyst is lazy, kind of a mess.
Yeah,
but funny.
I mean, I'll have to think about that. When I come up with my gemstone, I will let everyone know.
Okay, but what would you do if?
Oh, what would I do? I would hang out with Amethyst.
Okay.
definitely. And all of them. And all of the crystal gems,
probably
really.
Probably amethyst fusing with amethyst.
We would get the bits. The yeah. bits.
Thank you.
The bits. The bits. The
bits. Who's your favorite homeworld gem?
Homeworld gem. Peridot. I love that Dorito.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hello. My question is, I have two. How long have you been singing and how did you start?
Singing? Mm-hmm. Oh gosh, I was such a precocious kid. I probably would just like sing. I've been singing for a really long time. I started taking singing lessons probably when I was around 8 or 9. One of my childhood best friends, who I'm still best friends with to this day, when I was like 8, I used to like make her listen to me sing. Like I would just like I would be like, okay, so it's time for Grace to perform for you. Aww. Like I would just like sit her down. It was honestly really obnoxious of me, and I don't know why she put up with me. But I've been singing for a while, and it's really fun for me. It's something I love doing.
Okay. And my next question is, what was your reaction when you found out Nicki Minaj was going to play Sugalite?
Well, I wish I met Nicki Minaj. I wish that I had gotten to meet her. I don't want to say surprised, but I was like, whoa. And I think that was a lot of people's reaction to like, whoa, how's that going to turn out? And the moment I saw that episode, the title of it is slipping my mind right now.
Coach Steven.
Coach Steven, okay. The moment I saw Coach Steven and I heard how it sounded, it was absolutely phenomenal hearing how well Nicki or Miss Minaj seemed to really combine the energies of amethyst and garnet and like in its most like chaotic form. I don't know. I'm like really reading deep into it, but it was just like it was cool the way how well her voice put that together. And I honestly don't think it was just like, oh, let's get a celebrity name to get like a big draw for like a guest, because honestly, I do think that her voice fit the part well.
Thank you.
Hi. I have a question and I guess a favor.
Okay.
The first question would be, what would be your favorite human out of Beach City other than Connie, obviously?
Ronaldo. I actually have a Keep Beach City Weird sticker on my laptop. Ronaldo. I think he's hilarious.
And also, I'm wondering, I can record you trying to sing the theme in Connie's voice.
Okay. All right, I can try. Okay. Wait, my voice is like not in its best position right now, and I'm going to try, but... All right. Wait, can we pull up the theme song and I can sing along with that? Acapella is a lot of pressure, you guys. I'm not sure if I know all of the lyrics to the full version. All right. I know you guys will probably have my back.
Someone's ready.
Oh, I kind of do know the lyrics.
I can make it into.
Okay, I know the lyrics better.
We have about 10 minutes left after this song. Unfortunately, I know. This has been a really fun panel.
Yeah, this has been really fun. I love talking to you guys.
Look, she's going to be at her table right after this.
Yeah, yeah. I might take a little lunch break-ish sort of thing because I'm unfortunately still on Los Angeles time, so I didn't get to bed until kind of late.
It is.
Because
we're good and evil never beats us. We'll win the fight and then go out for peace. Do you want to start over?
All right, we need the countdown of when it's going to go.
Oh. One, two, three.
If you're evil, the four of us taking you down. Cause we're good and evil never beats us. We'll win the fight and then we'll go out for pizzas. We are the crystal gems. We'll always find a way. And if you think you can't,
oh,
we'll always find a way. That the people of this world believe in garnet, amethyst, and pearl, and Steven, and Connie.
I'm sorry, I tried. My voice is really cracking right now. I've been chugging like hot tea and coffee and cough drops all day.
I think that needs a big round of applause, personally.
I tried.
So
cute.
Thank you so much.
That was like the most adorable thing I've ever seen. Thank you. You're so cute.
Hello.
Hey.
I wanted to ask a question.
Wait, Louisa, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool. I've learned so many names and I feel so bad. I'm just like,
remember our names?
Please don't quiz me right now.
Have you or anyone in the cast of Steven Universe see those theories that fans make, and do you think they're probably very spot on whenever?
Sometimes I definitely, some people predicted that Garnet was a fusion from really early on. Yeah. And I didn't know at the time I read it, and I'd be like, that would be interesting. Wow. Definitely there are, Some things that some of the fans come up with, and I'm like, you're not too far off. You're not far off.
And do you think with any of the new speculations coming up for the newest seasons that maybe they could go towards that direction or not?
I've heard some theories that are a little far-fetched and some that are a little bit more plausible, but I definitely think that there are hints that are dropped in the show. Everything is thought out in such a way that everything I feel like has been planned out for a really long time. So it's all just gonna fall into place as more episodes air.
Alrighty, thank you.
Hello. Well, I want to ask, you said that you started this when you were like around four, like your whole voice acting career, right? So how did you balance that with all of school and right now since you're in college and everything? So how did you balance all of that?
Okay, well, I started acting when I was four, and then I started voiceover acting when I was around six. And around when I was 10, I decided to just stick with voiceover acting, which is where I'm at right now. As far as balancing school goes, I was homeschooled for all of my life up until high school. And that really is why I was able to do a lot of what I did. But eventually I was like, I want to have the real high school experience, whatever that meant. And I ended up really enjoying myself just in lieu of the fact that it was a really big growing experience for me. Being homeschooled your entire life and then going to a real school sounds like a movie plot. Mean Girls, anyone? But no, my high school experience was nothing like Mean Girls. But I definitely got that joke sometimes when I said that I was homeschooled my entire life before. But doing voiceover is a lot more flexible than doing on-camera acting, so it's been pretty easy for me to balance going to auditions after school or taking some time off from school to go to auditions or to work. And now in college, I record Steven Universe out of LA, but I'm actually going to school in San Francisco right now. And so I have to travel back and forth when I record. And it's a lot more of a challenge than it's been in the past, but it's definitely worth it.
Thank you.
No problem.
Hi.
Hey.
My question is, if you could voice any character in Steven Universe, who would you voice other than Connie?
Ooh. I've always thought that Amethyst was really fun vocally. Because one of the things I love about Steven Universe is that we do group records a lot, so I get to record with Zach and Dee Dee, who plays Pearl, and Michaela Dietz, who plays Amethyst, and watching Amethyst do some of the wacky stuff that Amethyst has to say and do is always really entertaining. I remember, again, I don't remember the episode title, but I remember when Amethyst gem got cracked and she had to speak backwards. Indirect. Oh yeah, yeah. An indirect kiss. I remember working on that and watching. Okay, so what she did? She first said the line forwards, and then we played it back for her backwards, and she had to record it once more, imitating it backwards. Instead, and it was, so that way it would sound like even weirder. It was a strange process, but it was so cool. And I was like, that looks so fun. I want to do that. That looks hard, but I want to do that.
A bunch of fans replayed those in reverse and posted them on YouTube.
Yeah, I saw that. That was pretty cool. I was like, I remember when this was recorded.
Thank you.
No problem. Hey again.
All right, so right now I have two questions. My first question is, what would Connie's reaction be if she went to the kindergarten and found out what it was used for?
I think Connie's sci-fi imagination would go wild. She would probably love it and think it's the most interesting thing in the world. But at the same time, she would probably just like look at everything and be like, wow. But I feel like she would have some cool ideas as to how to help the crystal gems and Steven with everybody. Yeah, no, Connie would probably think that was a very eerie place, but a very interesting place with a lot of history.
All right, and my second question is, what would her reaction be if she found out that Amethyst came from the kindergarten?
I feel like Connie's a very understanding character. I don't think Connie would judge Amethyst for that. I think she would just want to know as much about that as possible because Connie's very curious and she has an insatiable thirst for knowledge.
All right, thank you.
We probably only have time for another question or two.
Okay.
We got 5 minutes left.
All right.
What would you say Connie's life away from Steven, her swords, is like at like school?
I feel like, man, it must be strange having this magical best friend as whimsical and, I mean, he is a child, but as childlike in spirit as Steven is, and then going to school and not being around that. So that must be interesting, but I'm sure she does amazingly in school, and I'm sure that all of her teachers love her. but I do think that she definitely itches to get out of class so she can go on another magical adventure.
Thank you.
Hi, I have a question about, my name is Amber, and I was wondering, do you think there could be an Amber gem of any sort appearing in the show in the future at all?
I don't see why not.
Thank you.
That would be cool if there was, and you'd be like, it's me.
Exactly. Hi.
Hey.
So I have a lot of questions, but I'm only gonna ask one. How different do you think Connie would be if she was raised by the gems?
I definitely think that everything would seem a lot more normal to her. I don't think everything would be as magically crazy as everything seems to her, because especially you can see this towards the beginning of the series, whenever Connie is around Steven and his life, she's just in awe of it. Even when it's scary, just so much awe. And I do think that if she was raised by the Crystal Gems, then she would just kind of like be like, oh, okay, that's normal. Like, I grew up with that.
Thank you.
All right, here's our final question.
Well, I have just one question. Okay, so I know this is actually Pearl's line, but apparently Pearl's not coming to this convention. So I was wondering if you could say in Connie's voice, in a half-tired, half kind of narcissistic voice, I don't get tired, I get results.
I don't get tired, I get results.
Awesome.
Well, we will end it on that. Can we get one more round of applause for Grace Rolek?
Thank you guys so much for coming out. Amazing. I've had a lot of fun talking to you guys. Bye.